Hi guys, you're welcome once again to another recipe from Navina's kitchen. So guys, in today's recipe is going to be all about coconut fried rice. So here are the chicken which I'm going to use for cooking for today, and I'm just going to spice it up with my spices. You're free to apply or to use any other spice you have right in your disposal in your kitchen. So which I'm using the salt, the Maggi, the garlic powder, thyme and seasoning cube. And I'm not using all of the seasoning cube because my chicken is not much. And I'm adding onions and paprika powder as well as my chili powder, okay? So don't add much if you don't like it too spicy. And I'm going ahead to just add water, then cover and cook for 10 minutes until it is soft. Alright, next is to prepare my turkey, which I'm going to use also for this recipe, and I'm just spicing it up with my spice. You can use the spice, like I said before, what you have in your disposal for your cooking. Guys, so if you don't like the mixture of chicken and turkey in your recipe, you can just go ahead using chicken either, or you can use turkey as well, but I like using both for my recipe. So I'm spicing this up and then mix it up together and let it sit for 30 minutes at least to marinate before using it for my cooking. Yes guys, so feel free to check on the description box below as I will be leaving the list and the names of all items I use for this recipe. So after mixing up my turkey, next is to proceed to chopping my onions and garlic into smaller parts, because this way it can easily melt when I'm using it for my food. And also I'm using the half of the bulb of onions. You are free to use one full onions for this, and also skip the garlic part if you don't like the smell of garlic in your food, guys. Alright, after cooking my chicken for about 10 minutes, my chicken is still not ready, so I'm just flipping this over to remove the excess of spice on my chicken, and then I'm just going to fry this later on with my vegetable oil because I don't want my chicken to be really really soft while cooking. So yes, next is my gizzard, and I'm using 1 kg gizzard for this. I'm going ahead to add some few salt, water, and then cook for a few minutes before adding my seasoning into it. And while my gizzard is cooking, I'm just going straight up to add 3 tablespoons of vegetable oil into a clean fry pan, bring to a heat, then fry my chopped garlic and onions until it is golden brown. And I'm cooking this in the medium heat. I don't want it to get brown, so be careful while doing this. So yes guys, this is light brown. I'm still going to fry this a little bit more to get it a little bit darker brown, and then scoop it and set it aside for my next frying. And now back to my gizzard. So after cooking my gizzard for about 10 minutes or so, now I'm just going to add my seasoning powder and then cook again for the next 2 to 3 minutes. So guys, here is my rice, and I'm using the basmati parboiled type of rice. I really love this basmati product. The product is really nice, so you're free to use other products you desire or you like for your recipe. So yes guys, and then I'll just continue to wash this rice, and I'm washing it twice to remove enough of starch because we all know rice is a carbohydrate food. So I'm just going to wash my rice carefully to remove enough starch, and also the pesticide using preserving it during the bagging. And also, if you buy your rice from an open market, make sure to thoroughly wash it before using it also for your cooking. So now it's time to cook my rice, but before I do that, I'm just going to get my little sieve to sieve my chicken broth because I won't be needing all those onions or those thyme stem that came after cooking my, you know, my chicken. So I'm just going to throw that off, then add my coconut milk. Okay, I'm using 1 tin of coconut milk. So if you don't have this liquid coconut milk, you can use approximately 2 coconuts to make this recipe. So yeah, that is it. So before I add my rice, I just go ahead to have a taste of it, you know, because my broth already contains some seasoning and my salt wasn't enough, so I just added a little bit of salt before adding my rice to it. So I'm just going to cover this and cook until it is soft. After cooking my gizzard for 10 minutes now, my gizzard is finally ready. Now I'm just going to chop it and then continue with the next, which is to fry my shrimps. So here is my shrimps guys. So you can use the parboiled shrimps as well for this. So I'm just going to spice it up a little bit with my chili powder and my seasoning cubes powder. Yes, and it is like this, it's perfect. And I'm doing this in a very low heat so that it doesn't get burnt. So back to my rice has been cooking. Next is to test it to see if it is soft already, but my rice was not soft enough for my liking, so I decided to to add a little bit of water, then continue cooking until it is ready. So here are my shrimps. It is ready. Now I'm just going to scoop it out, then continue with the next frying. Alright, my next fry is my gizzard, so I just decided to chop my gizzard into smaller part. That way it's easier to chew and eat when you're eating it with your rice. So you can see my fry pan is kind of dry, there is no oil, so I just added a little bit of oil and then spice off my gizzard to make it a little bit tasty. Yes, so I'm being careful with my chili powder because my kids, they don't like too much spicy. So if you like spicy, just go ahead and add a little bit few more pepper to your gizzard. So here is my gizzard after frying for a few minutes. It's not that hard because I don't like it too hard. Okay, yeah, so guys, that is it. So my next should be my turkey. Yeah, so this is my turkey after 30 minutes of marinating. So I won't be adding any other spice to my turkey. I'll just stir fry. So my oil wasn't enough like before, so I just decided to add a little bit of butter. Guys, this give it a some aroma. Okay, adding butter to my turkey during frying will give it lovely aroma. So that is it. I'll just stir fry this, continue frying until it is a little bit dry and ready. Alright, so after frying my turkey for a few minutes, my turkey is finally ready. I'll just scoop this and then set it aside while I continue with the other frying. So now I'm just going to continue frying, which is the all ingredients and my vegetables. So my oil wasn't enough, I just added a little bit more oil to my fry pan, then add my green beans and my carrot, which is the other part of my vegetable. So I'm just going to cook this for about 2 to 3 minutes to make it a little bit softer. Okay guys, this recipe has to do with a lot of frying, so you should be patient and should have the time to do all the frying in the right way. So yes, next is to add my sweet chili and then my green peas and my sweet mace. I'm just going also to stir this together and then fry this a little bit more before adding my colorful bell pepper, because I don't want my bell pepper to melt. So that should be the last of the ingredient. So after adding all the ingredients together, I just spice it up a little bit with my garlic powder, with my curry powder, and also with my seasoning cubes. At this point, you can as well add your pepper, okay? I mean the chili pepper, the grounded pepper, or your bell pepper, okay? But I don't like it too much spice. I don't like too much pepper in my food, so I'm just careful, like I said before, because of my kids, okay? They don't really like it. I'm also going ahead to add my fried onions and garlic into my vegetables, as well as my other ingredients like my gizzard, my shrimps, and also my turkey. Yes, I'm going to mix all these ingredients together and then steam it between 3 to 5 minutes in a very low heat, because I don't want it to get burnt. You don't want to do this in a high heat, because don't forget your vegetable doesn't contain lots of water, and if you do this in a high heat, it's going to get burnt, okay? And that will change the taste of your food. Alright beautiful people, so after 5 minutes of steaming my vegetables, look at how it is looking. It's looking so delicious, guys. Don't you see how it is looking? Yeah, it's looking so amazing. So yeah, this is it. So after cooking this for few minutes, like I said before, I just tasted it and my pepper wasn't enough, as well as my seasoning wasn't enough as well, so I just add a few bits of both and then yeah, fry this again for about 2 to 3 minutes, then it is ready, guys. Alright lovely people, so after steaming my vegetable for a few minutes, so it's now for me to mix up my rice and my vegetables together. But as you can see, my frying pan wasn't big enough, so I decided to separate my vegetables into two parts before mixing. But before then, I had to add my desiccated coconut powder into my vegetable. This is just to increase the aroma, because if the coconut milk I used in cooking my rice wasn't enough, okay, the aroma wasn't strong enough, this powder is going to increase the aroma, okay? That is, you will feel the coconut smell from your rice. So yes, that is it, guys. So you can see how beautiful it is looking. I'm just going to mix this up thoroughly until it is combined, then cover and then steam it up again for the next 3 to 4 minutes, so that the aroma will comes up, okay? The aroma will become stronger. Yes guys, so this is a lovely dish, okay? I want you to give it a try back home home in your kitchen. And if you do, please come back to leave a review, how it tastes, how it's delicious, and how you think, I want to think about this rice in general. Okay guys, so that is it for today. If you like my videos, don't forget to leave a comment behind, thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe to my channel for the next update guys. So that is it for today. So thanks for watching and see you on my next one. Take care and stay blessed. Bye.